There is much more than simple winter beauty to Muir Reservoir in Littleton. There's a lot of history. Beneath the snow, at the bottom of the icy waters, there used to be bustling communities.
Main Street went this way, and Bridge Street went that way, and those stone walls are still there.
They're leftover evidence from the villages of Pattonville and Waterford, submerged underwater in the 1950s when a hydro dam was built. It's an unusual piece of history that is now part of a rather unique tour.
Welcome to the Muir Reservoir.
Margie Emmons runs Still Waters Run Deep kayaking and snowshoe tours.
Oh, we just love to get out in nature and refresh, get out of the office. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Great.
Good.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
She likes to take clients to different, often overlooked places and teach about history and nature.
Porcupines don't actually throw their quills. The animal that attacks them gets them stuck to them.
To help connect even more to nature, Margie loans out traditional wooden snowshoes.
Oh, they're just so much more natural. They're what the Native Americans used, and they feel right.
While wooden snowshoes are not as common, they still work great for hikes like this. Some people love the tradition, which is why you still find them being made just like the old days.
But I think it just has something to do with the webbing. It just holds you up better than the modern shoes.
Bill Novacek carries on an age-old craft in a workshop in Lancaster. Few still do.
Was there some point in time when you started this, you said, I'm going to do this as a business?
Yeah. And my wife said, you're crazy.
Bill handcrafts the wooden footwear for his company, Coos Canoe and Snowshoe. He says there's still a niche market for people who prefer the old school shoe.
Trapping or rabbit hunting or foresters, fish and game officers, people that like to be traditional.
Over time, he's mastered this craft, which all starts with a thin strip of ash wood, boiling water, and a pre-made form.
You know, a bunch of wood this size here, I'll boil it for maybe an hour at the most.
Okay.
And then when it's ready, it's all hot in there, you got some rubber gloves on, and you put it on and get it centered, and then you just pull it around.
You are left with a familiar looking shape.
Do you know this is strikingly similar to a tennis racket?
Yes.
After supports are added, the webbing is hand threaded. It's made from cow or deer hide. This can take a while. Bill has a variety of models, some as long as 6 feet. Some designed for heavy weight, others for speed.
This way, they're narrow, so you can run in them, and they have a curve on there so you don't get bogged down in the snow.
Bill has taken those same materials and techniques and now makes furniture too, like tables and travel seats.
Want to go on a picnic or go to your camp and you want to lug things with you, it's nice to have something that...
Oh, look at that.
Folds up and you put them right in your trunk.
Practical and beautiful at the same time, which takes us to our next stop. This is Peter Broy. He spends much of his time handcrafting wood furniture in his Concord workshop.
Now, I'm a custom woodworker. That's my primary business. I make furniture. I've been doing that for decades. So working with wood was easy.
Peter is also well known for another wood product. These are roller skis. When Peter Broy isn't crafting wood, he's coaching cross-country skiing here at the Derryfield School.
That's good, Darby. That's nice. Good, good, good.
But in New England, winters don't always come with enough snow to ski.
And there was no snow. In the beginning of the season, we needed to teach ski technique, and with roller skis, you can teach ski technique.
So Emmett, I want to see some classic technique, okay? I want to see you trying to kick, going up.
To get the kids training when there's no snow, Peter went to what he knew. He created his own version of the roller ski out of wood.
The wood shaft, this is this laminated birch shaft, has a nice flexibility, feels like a ski, and absorbs the vibration in the road.
He started a company called Wood Ski, and demand for the wooden roller ski came from all over.
Somebody from Florida says, yeah, I really want a roller ski down here. Okay, we'll send them to Florida. Why not?
Nowadays, he and his team use roller skis as part of their training.
It's pretty fun. It's exciting.
But his company has turned to another wood product.
So now, there's about 100 of these tables out there that are being used by all the top clubs and teams and here in New England.
Peter custom designed a table for waxing Nordic skis out in the elements. Chances are, if you're at a local ski race, you'll see a wood ski table.
You'll see that Middlebury, Dartmouth, UNH, University of Maine are using the tables.
So, thanks to Peter Broy, he's got Nordic skiers gliding along just fine, snow or not.